going to have to remember how I used to do all of this, going live directly. Okay, there I am. I can see me. No, that's my other one that was playing off. Gonna make sure I, there we are. Now I can see me. Let's bring up that screen. Let me bring up the comments. So I'm gonna apologize in advance if I don't see comments. Am I got an echo now? Yeah. Oh, hang on. There we go. Oh! Just had my volume on. Okay. Are we better? I think we are slightly clearer. Maybe I've just got a really bad internet connection today. So we are, hopefully we are here. Okay. I'll have to try and keep an eye on comments. I apologize if I miss comments. We are back. Hooray. Hooray. Okay, so back to Country Birdhouse. Now you can see how pretty it is. I've got some little bits already lined up. Thank goodness for that, huh? Okay, so we have the birdhouse, and then we've got a little bit of floral, but you can actually make it quite floral if you wanted to, or you can just have it like not so floral, which I think is really pretty. So you can still do the real dainty feel to it, is what I guess I'm saying. So the dies will cut out our shapes, and then we have the post. We have little elements here that we can add to build our birdhouse and give it a different look. So you can stamp it or you can just die cut it. And I'm assuming that I'm going okay because I haven't actually seen any comments yet. So if you just want to let me know that we are actually working on here as well. We have a post and we have some flowers and some leaves and a little hanger. So that is fun. And now you can see the pearls that are really pretty. So we've got dark and light silver pearls. So just jump in, I assume. I can't see comments, but hopefully you're all catching me again. Okay, I suppose I should have given you a few minutes to race over and catch up. Okay, so the papers, which, hello, Elizabeth has found me again. Now I can show you the papers. I should just wait a few minutes, right? So, there we go. Yep, I should just wait, because I know that there's a little bit of a lag, so now I can see everyone starting to come back. So, like I was saying before, this paper is absolutely beautiful. There's only four colours, and they're all, like, solid colours. There's no mixed, like, they don't use multiple colours on the one sheet, they're just plain colours, which I actually really like. So we've got Smoky Slate. This is the new Basic Beige, which I actually quite like as well. And then we've got Misty Moonlight and some Petal Pink. So we've just got beautiful, plain, solid colours that have got patterns on them. Super, super pretty. Oops, this one. There we go. So I've just got a little bit of, like, this is like linen texture. Really sweet. Very nice, like denim. Very nice. Okay, so, we're back, everyone. Yeah, that app is going to be, that's why I don't think I used the app before, because I was struggling with it, and I was just like, don't like it. Okay, so I have cut out, because I'm actually using these for my next month's membership. I've already got a few little bits and pieces that I had already done, but I've got the bird here and I want to, very quiet, maybe it's my volume. How's that? Is that better? It's probably because, here, I'll try and sit closer and I'll try and talk louder as well. I don't know whether turning the volume up on my phone matters or not, but that's what I've done. So I've got the bird, and the other cool thing that I can do now that I'm streaming natively is actually zoom in. So we're going to do a little bit of colouring, but we're going to use, what did I use before? Misty Moonlight. Yes, Misty Moonlight, and I'm going to use a bit of grey, and I'm going to use a bit of pink. So we're going to colour our bird in all of these colours. Okay, so what I have done to start with, is that better? Is the volume better? Or I'm just going to have to sit closer to the camera. Okay, so I'm just going to pop down a little bit of the Night of Navy. Not of Night of Navy. Misty Moonlight. It's going to be one of those days, I can tell. So I'm just going to pop down a little bit of the blue. I'll just call it blue. Okay, Smoky Slate Dark. So I'm just going to pop, and I'm not going to go over the whole of the blue like I would normally. I'm just going to bring that in a little bit because these two colours will blend nicely because they're both like the same type of value. They're both a dark blue. What did I do on the... I've coloured this one in before and in this particular style, so I'm just having a look. So let me know, have you done any unusual colours of blends? I mean, this one's pretty unusual, blue into grey into pink. So this one's pretty... It's disaster day. Why is it disaster day today? It's disaster streaming. Okay, so now I'm doing the light smoky slate. And just adding a little bit more to it. Okay, and then this is where the fun part comes in because I'm going to add petal pink. So I'm using the petal pink dark. And I'm going to start from the top, colour in that area. And then I'm going to actually go over the top of the grey over there. And then I'm just going to work this petal pink into the grey. And what will happen is this lighter colour is actually going to eat into the, well, that's what I call it anyway. It sort of eats into that grey and sort of makes it a little bit lighter. You get almost like a little speckledy texture to it as well, which I think is quite cool, especially for a little bird. Like a little mottled, and then you can sort of dot it, and it'll like it's almost like it almost acts like the colour lister. It sort of releases a bit of that colour, and you get that. Hi, Lisa. Sorry, I'm streaming live. Did the sound pick up? Hopefully. Okay, so now I'm going to remember to actually come back. Okay. One of those days where we're having streaming issues, so apologies, and if you're finding me from YouTube, thank you for coming over. It's not a happening thing for me, and I haven't gone live natively in YouTube, so to know what I would be doing over there, so I thought this is probably the easiest for me. So let's die cut this little bird, and then we can start working on our birdhouse. Okay, I'll gather my thoughts. It always, you know, when these things, they come and they test you and they muck you up for a little bit and until you get back into the flow of it all. Right, that'll be fine. So how's that? What do you think of that bird? He's a little bit different. He's a little bit different with the colouring, but I like it. Okay, so I've got him and I think that's all the elements that I'm going to use at the moment. So let's get stuck into cutting our, I don't know what papers I'm going to use, we'll figure them out in a minute, but I am going to do a pink birdhouse, and what I love is that these actually will all fit in the mini. All the dies will fit beautifully in the mini, so you don't have to bring the big machine over. And you can stamp. I think I was going to stamp it, but I've forgotten now because I'm a little bit mucked up in my brain. I was going to stamp it. Well, I will give you a tip for the stamping. Let me just get that die back in. Hello, back again, Deb. I'm glad you've gotten over here. I think I was going to stamp it because I was going to show you, but anyway. So when you pull this out, it's got a lot of space down the bottom, and of course I've got such a lag that I can't see whether I'm in the right spot. Okay, so we've got a little bit of a space. So if you put it down and it's got too much of like a curve on the bottom here, your die isn't going to cut out properly. So you need to make sure, whether you're on grid paper or your glass mat if you've got one, just make sure that this bottom part here is in a nice straight line when you put your block on top, because that way you'll have a nice straight edge to die cut off there. Okay, so just be aware of that when you when you're putting that onto your stamp. I will get my words out. Okay, what else do I need? I need my toppers, so I'm gonna grab. I'm going to use predominantly definitely going to be pink and blue, I think. So I'm going to grab, that one there. And this is cool because you only need to use your little scraps. And I'm going to grab, that one there, and that one will nest in there. And then I think I'm going to grab this one here. So that's the little hole for the birdhouse. We can die cut all of them together. Outline your dies. It's becoming a regular habit now. Outline your dies so you know where they go back. So I'm just using one of those art line fine liners, just like the little felt tip nib on the end of it, and just zoom around before you start using them. Because I tell you what, it has made a huge difference to keeping my die sets nice and tidy. Alright, so I've got them. I also need the base. So I'm just pulling out scraps out of my drawer. Grab the little base. I didn't want to do too much die cutting, but I wasn't actually 100% sure what I wanted to do with the house, so. But now that I've got everything coloured in, I think I'm over the green. The green that I'm using is Old Olive. You can use any green that you fancy. So I thought being muted colours, the Old Olive would be a nice one to go with. And I need a little bit more pink. And I need the fine one. So there's three pieces that go with that top. So that one's a nice fine one. And then once we got all our elements together, it's just a matter of building the birdhouse. See if we can get them off. There we go. Right. I think I have got everything that I want. I will figure out the sentiment afterwards and what I will probably white emboss, but I'm not sure on what colour as yet. So we'll leave that for a moment because I've got to work out what papers I'm going to put behind. But I do know that I want to do a little bit of ink blending. So, and I'm only going to do it on the third house itself. So ink blending is a really nice way. You don't have to do it, but I think it warms up your card really nicely. So just something that you can see. And I'm going to tap off onto my glass mat here and then just wipe that on. Now, because I'm going to have all these little bits and pieces on top, I can actually bring that down quite a bit because otherwise it will all get covered and I won't see it. So I'm going to bring the top of the house down. The sides of the house I'm just going to leave not so much on there. And then the bottom, I'm going to actually bring that up because that'll get covered by the bottom piece as well. So I sort of almost want that little area in there to be nicely ink blended. Okay. Just to give it that nice little halo. Alright, actually I'll leave that out. Wipe my area. I'm assuming you guys can hear me. Kayla says, sounds, have I got it on the wrong phone? Oh, okay. Very, very quiet. Oh, I don't know what's going on, honestly. Put the volume up on that. Not that I think that makes any difference. Oh, you know what? I'm just going to have to soldier on. I can't. It's just a poo day. That's what it is. It's a poo day. You guys can see what I'm doing anyway. All right. So we're just going to do a little bit of texture. It's a poo day. Can I say that? Because I'm only watching on my iPad, so I know it's not my iPad, it must be my phone. Microphone. But bear with me for 2 seconds because I've just pinched my thumbs. I just need the cord. Maybe I just won't chat so much. How about that? I'll see if I can somehow boost the volume in the replay or something. We are not friends with technology today. Alright, let's pop our blue down the bottom. Can't be getting too hung up over it, right? Pink on pink, but it's sort of like a little bit of a placeholder. I'm going to actually use my other one. And just dotting some glue on. Because I've done some ink blending, that will actually come up a little bit lighter. Hold that in. Honestly, today is not a good day. I don't know why. This nasty guy. Okay, pop this one in. How cute is that? When it doesn't stick to your fingers, it is pretty cute. Okay, we've got him built. Oh, okay, we need paper. I've got my card base. Whisper white card base. Basic white, I mean. Oh, not whisper white. No, no. So we've got that, and he's going to go on there. So he does fill up a fair bit of that space, which is good, because it means that you don't have to do a whole lot of work around the back. But let's pick some papers out. You know what? I haven't used this one yet, so we might just use that one. Oh my gosh. And now the postie's here. Holy cow. Be back in a sec.
Happy with our card because we don't want to just rush through. So much for
for all my tips and helping you out and when things don't go the way that they're supposed to. All right. And that might be a little bit hard to see. I might have to come back and do that in black or blue, actually, because that's going to be quite hard to see. We'll do that as well, because that will take me 2 seconds. And I'm still trying to get things organized for this Mexico trip, because people in Mexico don't really want to email you back. I still don't have a ride from the airport to the hotel, which is like an hour and a half away, because they don't email you back for the price. Very stressful and very frustrating. Even the travel agent can't get hold of them. So, like, do they want your business or do they not want your business? Happy birthday stamp too. Oh, you can see that, not too bad. I haven't stamped it very well, mind you. And I need to take my guard off and give it a clean because I can't see through it because it's got glue spots all over it. Okay. Get you on. Alright, now you'll be able to take your pick as to what one we think is going to work. Alright, so there's my pink, which... And then I have to work out a placement. Will it go down the bottom? So that's pink, which actually might be quite nice down there. And then, because I can always put some more fluff around it. Let's get this one cut and we'll make an executive decision. Huh? Nice and straight, which I don't think it is. So you see how, like, you can still make it quite pretty and feminine without having a whole heap of florals on it? Like, it's just got a tiny little bit of floral, but it's still really quite pretty and feminine. Okay, so, and then we've got the blue. So I'm thinking you guys were right. I'm thinking it's going to be happy birthday, and I think it will be down the bottom. Done. Okay, let's get this baby stuck together. Peel all the pieces off. Get the proper glue out. We could even tatty up the corner on one of these layers. So, because if we tatty that up, it's going to show pink on the other side, which is pretty cool too. So let's get that done. Tatty you up. Put you down. And let's need to keep pushing up. There we go. And pop you there. Probably give you a tatty edge as well. Tatty you up. Oh, that's got a nice scratch in it now. And that's for you as well. We've just flipped the card over, so we've got opposites. That's pretty cool. Awesome. Okay. Let's do dimensionals. Pretty easy. We're just going to stick it straight bang in the middle, and then you can sort of just place all your little flowers wherever you fancy. Here in the middle, because now I've got crooked layers, I'm going to feel like I'm crooked. I'm going to stand up for this. Because when I've got crooked I feel like I'm crooked. Alright, let's get these guys down. We'll do them first. Now, just put a little bit of adhesive right in the middle because I'll flip my, I'll put my, what do you call it, leaves and stuff underneath. We'll put you, we can give that a little bit of space because we're going to pop our bird there so they don't need to be overlapping each other because the bird will overlap them nicely. And then we'll grab some of these leaves and it's just a matter of just popping them wherever you fancy. Getting glue on everything now. Okay, so you just chuck them under. Now there are single leaves as well as the double ones. Just as well my volume's not doing too well today because the bin man's out there and he's making a hell of a noise. Up there. Under there. I've got five. I've got a few more here, so I might pop them in a little bit later. I've also got that flower, and I've got a single flower, and of course I've got all these. I've die cut some of these blue ones as well. But we'll fiddle with them after. We'll pop you in and we'll put the sentiment in and then we'll figure out if we want to add any more fluff. Because you can go to town with these and some of the cards I actually have. Pop you down. They're not stuck properly, they're all around. Put our happy birthday down. Now, beware because I've got height here and I've got height here, so you have to be aware of where you're putting your dimensionals because I don't want it to hang off too much and I need a little bit of glue on this side to attach him to the bird. I could have put the bird up a little bit higher, but he'll just be popping out from behind the sentiment. To the bird and he'll attach here. So now I can see whether I want to put some more little green leaves poking around, which I think I do. And it's good because there isn't any green in the papers or anything, you can just use whatever green you want. And you only need to use a little bit because it just gives that little bit of a pop. And then I'm going to pop these ones down just to balance everything up. I'm going to pop them over on this side and they're going underneath. And I don't think that I will use any of these other ones. You can by all means, but I think I've got enough curvature going on. And I also want my things of these. So let's get all of that tied up. Because I'm finally finished! Muck up day. Okay, and because I've got a lot of blue going on, I think I'll use the darker of the pearls and pop one down there, and then I'll use a couple of the smaller ones in my triangle fashion. So there we have. Whew! Not pretty card, terrible live. How about that? Pretty card, but a terrible, dreadful live. Oh well, it happens to us all, doesn't it? So there we go. There's that one. I've got lots of little extras to play with now for another card. So that one's sort of like a bonus. Now, these are the cards. I'm going to do a real quick flick through. These are the cards that I've got for the Card Makers Club at the end of the month, at next month. So we've got lots of cute little cards, so just a real quick flick through. So I will be away when these go live, but they will all be ready to go. So if you are wanting to do Card Makers Club, you have until the 30th of April to get signed up for that. this is like a bonus. And the other bonus is that Lisa and I, Lisa from the States, are actually going to be using this suite as well for our thank you PDF, but I'm going to break away from these colours and I'm going to move into some different colours because I've only been playing with these colours, so it'll be nice to break away. So you'll get, if you're in Creative Card Makers Club, you'll get the 6 tutorials, plus you've got this one coming out. This one will come out in my newsletter next Tuesday. If you purchase in May, then you'll get the free tutorial, the free thank you tutorial, which will have another 6 cards using this suite as well. So you'll have Birdhouse overload, but trust me, you'll want to. It's nice for something different. I think it's nice. You know, when we want to do florals, we want to do feminine, but we don't want to do too much florals. So I think this is pretty nice. Now, somebody had asked me for a Mother's Day card as well. I struggle with Mother's Day cards because I don't have my mum anymore, so if you want to do a Mother's Day card, just switch out your sentiment and pop a Mother's Day card for, you know, sentiment for any, if you wanted to do this, because I think that these would be a pretty Mother's Day card as well, so very nice and feminine. I have to try and see whether I can masculine one up. See, now I'm looking at it and it doesn't look straight. I think it's straight. I don't know. Anyway, I'm going to go and sort out and try and figure out what is going on with that Streamyard app, and if I have to keep using it, because if that's the way it's going to be, then I don't want to use it if it's that glitchy. So I'm going to have to go and do some research now. And hopefully next week will be a little bit better. I'm hoping to be here next week because then we leave on the Tuesday. And if I have got all of my projects done and I am running on time and I've got all of my work done, I will come in next week. If I don't, then I will have to skip next Thursday's live. So we'll see. Okay, that'll be it. I'm not feeling the love for this live stream, so I'm going to leave while I do a little bit of... Oh, I don't know. If you don't laugh, you cry, right? Okay, I will see you all later. Thank you for persevering with me. I know it's really bad, but... circumstances beyond our control, right? We'll hopefully cross fingers see you next week. Okay, take care. See you later.